Whenever the laws of any state are broken, a duly authorized organization swings into action. It may be called the state police, state troopers, militia, the rangers, or the highway patrol. These are the stories of the men whose training, skill, and courage have enforced and preserved our state laws. Peace officer is trained to use every possible precaution. In an emergency, however, the personal safety of the officer becomes a secondary issue. On October 3rd of last year, two desperate criminals, Lewis Bakeman and Chick McNabb, were the object of a statewide search by the Highway Patrol. Available information indicated they were heading for the border in a stolen pickup truck. Driving carefully and within the speed limits to avoid attracting attention, they were nevertheless sighted by an alert Highway Patrolman. Officer Wayne Hoffman carefully and properly began surveillance pursuit before taking his first step. A step that was to plunge him into an unforeseeable and desperate situation.
3352 to headquarters.
Headquarters by.
In pursuit of light green pickup truck.
Could be the hot car we've been looking for.
I got it. What's your 1020?
State Highway 21, 2 miles from Paradise Junction, moving north.
Keep vehicle under surveillance. Don't move in until you get help. 10-4?
10-4.
Get Hoffman some help.
Come here. Right. Where's 1330?
Cruising Latimer Pass Road.
Cutting back to Highway 21. Have him start south to intercept the pickup. Have someone follow Hoffman north on 21. Get a few more units in the area in case of a turnoff.
Headquarters to 1330. Headquarters to 1330.
See, here's State Highway 21. Right here is Paradise Junction. That should put the pickup truck right about here.
A lot of foothill roads in that area.
Yeah, I know.
There's a cop following us on a motorcycle.
Yeah? Slow down, I'll stop him.
Now take it easy, he's got a gun too. By now he's already called headquarters and given them our location.
What's he following us for anyhow? We haven't been speeding. Unless...
That's right. Unless they've found out that this is a stolen truck.
Well, if that's it, we're like sitting ducks.
Well, can you figure it any other way?
Come on, you're the figure guy in this outfit. Figure out what to do next.
It's a cinch. Well, where's that cop and ditch this truck? We'll take this next side road down here. And if he follows us, we'll split up and get him in the middle.
That's a lucky break. We're in the clear.
Except this place is going to be crawling with cops in the next 5 minutes. But if that guy isn't faking, he could be our ticket to freedom.
He's out like a light. Go up to the truck and get some rope. I'm going to show you how to get by the cops the easy way.
Highway Patrol searched in vain for Officer Hoffman, unable to find a trace of either the missing patrolman or his motorcycle. Bakeman and McNabb moved rapidly to find a temporary refuge. Knowing an intensified search would develop with the disappearance of the police officer, the criminals needed time to construct a foolproof plan, a daring plan that would carry them through the tightening police line.
Hoffman doesn't answer his call. Morgan and Harold just made contact on Highway 21. They report no sign of a pickup truck.
Try Hoffman again.
Yes, sir. Headquarters to 3352. Headquarters to 3352. Headquarters to 3352. Headquarters to 3352.
Gotta keep you alive, cop. You're our pigeon in case anything goes wrong.
Headquarters to 3352.
That's my call again.
Headquarters.
We're gonna let you answer it.
Okay, untie me.
That's wistful thinking on your part, copper.
Headquarters to 3352.
How does this thing work?
That button on top. That's a press to talk button. When that's pressed down, I can talk to headquarters. When it's released, headquarters can talk to me.
Good. I'm going to press this button down. And I want you to tell headquarters what happened.
Headquarters to
and tell them to call off the cops, or you're going to get a bullet in your skull.
And be careful what you say, cop. Be awful careful.
Headquarters to 3352.
3352 to headquarters.
Headquarters, bye.
I got it right now. I got it. Matthews, what's your 1020?
What does that mean?
He wants to know my location.
Are you there?
Don't know my 1020. Motorcycles, get it on. Turn off Highway 21.
When I recovered consciousness, I was disarmed and a prisoner of Bakeman and McNabb.
2150 to 3352. 2150 to 3352. Hoffman, come in. Do you hear me, Hoffman? Come in.
He's still here, but he's going to have a little headache in the morning. If he's still alive, that is.
Who's this?
Never mind who this is.
But just get this straight. We're in a bad spot. And if we're caught, we're finished. So we've got everything to gain and nothing to lose.
So?
So get all your cops and cars off the road for the next 24 hours.
What road?
All roads. If you try to pick us up, this guy gets it where it'll do the most good.
Okay, you're in the driver's seat.
Well, I thought you'd see it my way. Now, let's hear you call off your cops.
Headquarters to 8830. 8826 and 9240. Return to headquarters immediately. 10-4?
But our unit numbers don't go that high.
They don't know that. How many units we got on Highway 21?
Well, six within 20 miles of Paradise Junction and Highway 21.
Six. I want cars sent out to replace them. Make two of them undercover cars. Have the radio frequency changed. Also headquarters. Then we can talk and those two hoodlums can't hear us.
Right.
Send out that message. I want to make sure they got it.
Yes, sir. Headquarters to units 8830, 8826, and 9240. Headquarters to units 8830, 8826, and 9240. Return to station. Headquarters to units 8830, 8826, and 9240. Vicinity Highway 21. Signal 1019. Return to station.
Now, we're going to give them a chance to get those roads real clear. Then we'll make our move.
Headquarters to units 8830, 8826, and 9240. Return to station.
If they got Hoffman any place between Highway 21 and Paradise Junction, they got three main roads out of there. One, two, three.
Those roads are all covered.
Have our undercover unit start cruising the area. Have our regular boys stay out of sight. If they spot the truck, no pursuit, just a report of progress.
Do you think they'll keep Hoffman with them till they get him in the clear?
You think the cops will really pull out?
Maybe. But they'd like to save this guy if they can. Cops are smart. Don't you forget that. They're going to try something. So we've got to try something first.
Yeah, like pulling a car switch on, getting a real fast car.
No. This time we've got to get a closed truck, because we can't go around with that motorcycle hanging out the back end.
A police officer's tenacity and courage gave him one small hope. If he could manage to depress the push-to-talk button on his radio mic without being detected, it would transmit a constant impulse to Highway Patrol headquarters. Given sufficient time, the Highway Patrol would be able to use this impulse to pinpoint the truck's location and close in.
Well, have you got anything?
Well, units are getting into position. 2716 has just reported as 1020. Highway 60 and Crescent Boulevard concealed behind service station.
Oh, that's dandy. The carrier broken on channel one?
Yes.
The boys using the other channel?
Yes, sir.
Hoffman pushed on his talk button.
But we're not getting any message.
Yeah, but he knows with the carrier broken, we can get to him like a homing pigeon.
And that signal can only be coming from Hoffman's motorcycle.
Get directional finder equipment set up. One in Garvey's car, one in mine. Have the frequencies changed. And let's hope Hoffman's battery holds out.
Yeah, let's hope.
How about you?
Well, I think we can get underway now. Cops ought to be pretty well scattered by now.
I don't know if I like this setup or not.
Have you got any better ideas?
No. But just because we got our hands on a cop doesn't mean we're in the clear.
It helps. And they'll stay backed up until they find out which direction we're going.
And then?
Well, it depends. They're still looking for a pickup truck with two men in it. But if we can get a closed truck, with me driving and you on the inside with a cop, well, we've got a chance.
They're still liable to stop us.
But with you on the inside, with a gun pointing at the back of the cop's neck, the odds are in our favor. We're gonna take a little ride, Copper. It could be your last one. It all depends on your buddies.
FCC has been notified, and all the radios and directional finder equipment have been set.
We'll let you know when we pick up a signal. You give me the positions.
Right.
Highway Patrol. Yes. Yes, I see. I'll be very happy to give him that message. That's all right. Goodbye. That was Mrs. Hoffman. She forgot to get the candles for Junior's birthday cake. Wants Wayne to pick him up on the way home.
As long as the switch on Officer Hoffman's motorcycle remained open, the directional finding equipment could pinpoint the location of the motorcycle by the triangulation process. But the important element was time. The motorcycle had to be located before the battery failed. Following the beams between their equipment and Hoffman's radio, Matthews and Garvey moved constantly closer to the point where those beams crossed, hoping to find Officer Hoffman alive.
...1426 to headquarters.
Headquarters by?
I have a faint signal at about 312.
I get a reading of 047 degrees.
It was 039 a few minutes ago.
They might be in a vehicle in front of me. Check for variation.
A slight variation south.
All right, they're on the move.
About that truck back there.
I can get it easy. Back up.
To headquarters.
Headquarters by.
Hoffman motorcycle, probably in a moving vehicle. Now, we want to get close without them spotting us.
Use the high points in that area as a lookout. Have Lara be contact us and relay the information as soon as we get it fixed. 10-4?
10-4.
Reading holds steady now at 319.
I'll check for a possible position.
The motorcycle, put it in this truck.
Well, what do we need with a motorcycle? I thought the whole thing was set up.
We may need it again. If they try to pull something, I want to be able to talk to them. Come on.
I just lost the signal. What about you?
So did I. Either the battery went dead or they discovered the channel was open. What do we do now?
Why don't you tell me?
Broken, the highway patrol was forced to continue their search, aided only by the description of the pickup truck and its occupants. Hoffman, realizing the highway patrol had no way of knowing the fleeing criminals had switched vehicles, knew he must once again open the channel on his radio, even at the risk of his life.
Headquarters.
Headquarters by.
Position for Larrabee to check.
I get a steady 090 degree signal at 40 miles an hour. Position just crossing Dana's Creek on Highway 21. 10-4.
090 from Dana's Creek.
Position south edge Endicott Farm. Reading 170 degrees.
170. Headquarters to 2150 and 1426. You are in line with a suspect vehicle. Said vehicle is probably moving south on River Road. Stand by for check with River Road Lookout. 10-4.
10-4.
Headquarters to
42-12. Headquarters at 2150.
2150 by.
Report on vehicle in your fix from 4212 in lookout position. Panel truck, single driver, proceeding south on River Road at normal speed. No sign of motorcycle or of Hoffman.
Any other vehicle near the panel truck?
No other vehicle in sight.
Attention all units. Signal from Hoffman's motorcycle coming from panel truck traveling south on River Road, vicinity of Lane River Bridge.
This could only mean suspects have switched vehicles. Single driver indicates suspects have split or companion is riding inside the panel truck.
Possibility Hoffman's in the panel truck with the motorcycle. Still being held as hostage.
Stand by to set up roadblocks.
Nearest undercover car. Pick up the panel truck and trail from a safe distance in case of a turnoff.
Approximate point of roadblock, 24 miles south, just north of Lane River Village.
Have nearest unit to that point contact me right away. 10-4?
10-4. Headquarters calling units 1640, 1745. Headquarters calling units 1640, 1745.
2150 to 1426.
1426 by.
Rendezvous roadblock point. 10-4?
10-4.
Dan Matthews sought a way to trap the two fugitives without arousing their suspicions. He needed a roadblock. Not an ordinary roadblock, but one that would deceive Bakeman and McNabb. While a bus blocked the road, pretending an accident, highway patrol units converged on the area, shutting off all avenues of escape.
There's some trouble up ahead. Looks like an accident.
It could be a trap.
Could be. But they'll let us through, or we'll present them with one very dead cop. On your toes. Here comes a cop.
Hello, sir.
Hello?
We've got a bad accident up here, and we're trying to clear the road so traffic can move through. Give us a hand, will you?
Could be on the level. That cop thought I was Lewis Bakeman. He'd never turn his back on me.
Go take a look. We've still got a real live cop for a hostage.
Coming?
Yeah, I'm coming.
Did you get Bakeman?
Yeah.
Oh. By the way, here are the candles for your kid's birthday cake. I was afraid you might forget them.
Come on, untie me.
See Highway Patrol again next week. Until then, remember, if you care to drive, drive with care. This is Bradley Crawford saying, see you next week.
laws of any state are broken, a duly authorized organization swings into action. It may be called the state police, state troopers, militia, the rangers, or the highway patrol. These are the stories of the men whose training, skill, and courage have enforced and preserved our state laws. The strongest forces for effective police work all over the United States is the close cooperation between all law enforcement agencies. On February 18th, Whitey Sims, murder suspect and fugitive from Nevada, had been captured by the Highway Patrol. On the 19th, he was turned over to the custody of Sergeant Sampson of the Nevada State Police. It is this kind of well-coordinated joint effort that makes crossing a state line no advantage to a criminal.
He's a killer. He shot a bank cashier in the back with his hands raised.
Well, do you want us to stay around here till the train shows up?
No need. He's all bundled up and hasn't the place to go.
I was planning a vacation in Mexico.
I got news for you, kid. You blew it. Good luck, Sergeant. Take care.
So long.
All right, get out the keys to those handcuffs and make it fast. Nobody's taking my brother anywhere.
Take care of Sampson.
As a kid.
Not bad. Come on, let's roll.
Look, Fred's up on the street in the getaway car. You get up there as fast as you can. I'll hold him off.
What if he's not there?
You've got a gun. Use it. Grab the first car you can see, but get in touch with him as soon as you can.
What about you?
Don't worry about me. Get going.
Oh, come on now.
Get going.
Honey.
What do you want?
Your car. I'll start driving anywhere.
I got an ambulance on the way. He's still alive.
Stay with him. Whitey took off.
Whitey Sims, a ruthless killer whose present freedom had been gained at the expense of two more lives, now held a third life in his grasp. And Dan Matthews of the Highway Patrol knew this man's flight must be stopped at all costs before his desperate bid for freedom continued to leave a trail of death. Whitey Sims, clever, desperate, and ruthless, knew that his escape with Alice Carter had been spotted, and that he would not long be able to continue the race against the overwhelming odds of the Highway Patrol. He forced a terrified young woman to continue her frightening drive until he could find just the garage and car setup he hoped would trick the police.
Stay here, baby. Where do you live?
Please take my car and leave me here.
Where do you live?
3 blocks from here.
Anyone home?
My mother, she has a gift shop there. The apartment's behind it, but you can't stay there. People come in and out all the time. Besides, my mother's an invalid. She's in a wheelchair.
Oh, stop it. You're breaking my heart. You're taking me home with you, honey. And that, just as soon as I gimmick the ignition. Now, come on, get up.
$21.50 to headquarters.
Headquarters by.
I've lost him. I lost him somewhere between Ann and William Street. Set of roadblocks all around there. You've got descriptions and license.
What goes with Sampson?
He's on his way to the hospital.
Keep me informed. 10-4?
10-4.
My bag.
$21.50 to headquarters.
Headquarters by.
I want 2 units, one at Virginia and one at Williams.
But I'm coming in. 10-4?
10-4.
Alice?
Mother.
Who is that man? What does he want?
What I want is no trouble at either of you. Now, your daughter's been a good girl up until now. Let's see if you can be the same, huh?
The money is in the till behind that counter. Take it and get out.
Don't want your money. Right after her.
Goes to the apartment.
All right, let's go.
Young man, if you know what's good for you, you'll clear out.
Maybe you haven't noticed, madam, but I'm kind of hurt. I'd love to clear out, but I can't. Now, come on, move.
Do what he says, please.
No hoodlum with a gun is going to frighten me.
Lady, I'll kill you if I have to. Now move!
Oh!
You, get some boiling water and bandages. Quick! You get over there and stay there. Go on! Give me some scissors. What's that?
A customer, most likely.
Well, go wait on it. Remember, I'll be right behind this curtain. You make one mistake and I'll kill your daughter. Remember that.
I'll remember.
Sims was the most dangerous kind of criminal, running, wounded, already wanted for murder, and perfectly willing to kill again at the slightest provocation.
He's gone.
That's good. How's the hot water and bandages coming along?
In a minute.
Says a make on Whitey Sims' accomplice. It was his brother, Peter Sims.
Let's get something on Peter Sims, then.
Highway Patrol.
They removed the bullet. Doctor says Sergeant Sampson has a good chance.
Yes. Yes, that's the one. Now, what is that address? And the name? One moment, please. We've got a break. Now, Mrs. Sarah Burns, 1818 Oak Street, reports a car stolen from a garage. A convertible was left in its place.
Get a description of the car and contact me. Come on, let's move.
Mrs. Burns, can you describe your car, please? 55 station wagon, black. Thank you very much.
You know, you're not bad from some angles. You might even be passable. You get that sour look off your face. Hey, how come you're not married, Alice? How come she's not married?
That's none of your business.
Well, if it's yours, you sure didn't help him out much, did you? How old are you, Alice? How old are you? What are you getting sore at?
Fella asks a simple question, she gets sore.
Now, will you go?
I'll go when I'm ready.
Ah.
Don't you realize the longer you stay here, the more chance there is you'll be found?
Shut up!
I'm supposed to call a fella. It's busy.
Young man, you could show a little more respect for your elders. No, please!
You tell her to keep her mouth shut.
Mother, please.
He wouldn't dare.
Oh, now, listen, lady. If the cops get me, it's a murder rap. It's my life, you understand that? So if I have to kill you and your daughter, I will do it.
You are frightened, aren't you? And a frightened man doesn't think very clearly. You may kill us, Mr. Whatever your name is, but they'll get you.
You Mrs. Burns?
Yes, I am.
I'm Matthews, Highway Patrol. What do you know about this car?
Well, I was taking a nap when the music woke me up.
Music?
Yes, from the car radio. At first, I thought old Mrs. Linnet next door had her radio on too loud, as usual. So I came out to ask her to turn it down. Then I found it was coming from my garage. And when I opened the door, there was this car, and my own was gone.
Well, do you want to know something? We've been trying to find your car for the past 3-4 hours.
Headquarters to 2150.
Take it.
Headquarters to 2150.
2150, bye.
We checked the license on the convertible. It's registered to Alice Carter, 24 Front Street. 10-4.
10-4.
Thanks very much for your cooperation. We'll be in touch with you.
All right, start moving.
I'm Matthews, Highway Patrol. We're looking for an Alice Carter.
Alice is my daughter.
Have you heard from your daughter, Alice, in the past 3 or 4 hours?
She left this morning to do some shopping. Why?
Well, a guy picked up her car. He's an escapee, made her drive. I thought maybe they'd come here.
No, I haven't heard from her at all.
Does she live here with you?
Yes. We have the apartment in the back.
You see, this guy was wounded, and he's looking for a place to hide. I'll tell you, if you hear from Alice, call Highway Patrol right away, will you?
I will, Mr. Matthews. I'll phone you just as soon as I hear from her.
Don't worry about your daughter. Sims needs her.
I understand. She has good sense enough to do what is right. And my doctor has forbidden me to worry.
You know, that's awful good advice.
Things will work out, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm sure, too. Thanks a lot. Let's go.
He's gone. Alice, please.
Well, old lady, I sure gotta hand it to you.
He's inside there.
We'll have to watch that step with the 2 women in there.
Take a look down here. Case this. Mr. Brent's car.
That's it.
Let's look it over. Yeah, that's the car, all right.
There's blood on the floor mat.
Yeah, I know. How are we going to get him out of there without hurting the women?
And Mrs. Carter could help us?
Why don't you tell me? Tell you what, get on the horn, call headquarters.
Headquarters by.
We found Sims. He's holed up in a gift shop at 24 Front Street. Send two units as soon as possible. Use caution.
We'll come in from the rear. Have the units cover the front. 10-4?
10-4. Headquarters to units 2136 and 2762. Headquarters to units 2136 and 2762.
Carter's gift shop.
Mrs. Carter, this is Dan Matthews, Highway Patrol. I want you to pretend I'm your doctor.
Hello, Dr. Sugarman.
Sims is there, isn't he?
I'm still feeling the pain.
Can you get out of there with your daughter and leave him alone?
No. No, those pills won't work. I've tried them.
Is there a back entrance to your place?
Yes.
Is it open?
Yes, doctor.
We'll be coming in that way in a couple of minutes. You and your daughter get to one side of the room.
Well, all I can do is try and... Thank you so much for calling, Doctor. Dr. Sugarman is so thoughtful. He wants me to take more rest. Would it be all right with you if Alice put me to bed for my nap?
No, it wouldn't be all right with me. I want you both where I can see you.
Still frightened, aren't you? A frightened man is an angry man, Alice. I wonder how much of the violence in this world is committed by frightened men.
I told you to shut up.
We're two helpless women, and you have a gun. I wonder why you're so scared of us.
Who's scared? I told you to shut up!
Leave her alone!
You get back where you were!
All right, come on, drop it. Drop it!
No! You drop it! You come any closer and I'll kill this girl. Now drop it! Drop it! Move!
I'm getting out of here. If you try to stop me, you're not killer.
Now stay there!
Didn't give you much of a target.
That was enough.
Yeah, get Sims out of here, huh? I'm gonna have to take my hat off to you. You got an awful lot of moxie.
I couldn't worry or get excited. Doctor's orders. I have a bad heart.
Oh, well, let me tell you something. I wish ours was as bad. Thanks very much. See Highway Patrol again next week. Until then, remember, if you care to drive, drive with care. This is Bradley Crawford saying, see you next week.